Hi everyone, welcome to Sachii Online Academy. Today I'm going to take you through Java ArrayList. If you are new to this channel, guys, just click the subscribe button below and turn on the notification bell so that when I upload a new video, you get notified. And I'll be doing Java tutorials, guys, for you each and every week. So just subscribe to this channel. So let's start our discussion. Java ArrayList class uses a dynamic array for storing the elements, okay? And it is like an array, all those traditional array that you know, but this one, it have got no size limit. You don't have to know the size limit, but when you declare the traditional array, you have to explicitly define the size of that array. But with this one, you can dynamically install, store your elements. And also these ones are more flexible than the traditional array. You can add, you can remove elements with randomly, okay? So there are some important points that you have to know, guys, here about the array list, Java array list. Java array list can contain duplicate elements. Java array list class maintains insertion order. Also, Java ArrayList class is non-synchronized. Java ArrayList allows random access because array works at the index basis. Like you can access the index number 2 before accessing the index number 0. Okay, so you can randomly access by just explicitly define the index that you want to access. In ArrayList, manipulation is a little bit slower than the linked list in Java because a lot of shifting needs to occur if an element is removed from the ArrayList. Yeah, this is an important note, guys, because in a linked list, when you insert an element in a linked list and delete an element from the linked list, we don't need to shift the remain elements like here in ArrayList, because you have to give it an index in an array. So whenever you delete an element at index 2, it means that the elements which was at index number 3 will now move to the index number 2. So there will be a shifting on each and remove operation. Elements will be shifted in ArrayList. So guys, let me show you how to declare ArrayList and how to manipulate. But much of the methods I've already done them, when I was doing the. I want to create a new project. When I was doing the linked list, so many of the methods that you also use by the ArrayList methods used by the ArrayList are the ones which are used by the linked list, because the linked list also inherits some of its methods from the list, like the ArrayList also does. Okay, so here I'm going to create a new class, guys, for you. In this class, I have to include the main method and the name of this. I'm going to give it test, then finish. Okay. This is our project, guys. So here I'm going to show you the traditional array and how it operates, and then I'll show how the array list overcomes the traditional array and the advantages of what of ArrayList. Okay, so here I'm going to declare a string of names. I need an array of names which must be equal to new string, and here, guys, you have to define the size of the array. Okay, like let me put 2.
And let's say you want to insert elements, you want to insert names, you use the index, like at index 0, I'm going to insert what? This name, like Ezekiel, which is my name. Also, maybe at index 1, you have to initialize, maybe it's Jim. Okay, we already have two elements. This is the disadvantage of using what? Arrays than using array list. Okay, because if I try to insert elements at index 3 like this, let me say James. Yeah, guys, this one, it will give me an error when I try to run this, because here we have got three elements, but our size here is 2. Okay, at index, maybe it's index 2. Okay, so if you are using an array list, you have to declare your array list just like this. Array list n is being initialized to new array list, then the construct of the array list. I have to import here, guys, so let me control O just to import. Is it control O or shift? Okay, I was trying to use the shortcut for importing. I have to import, okay, this one, so that you can use this array list class. So here I can say n dot add. Okay, I can add elements here. I'll put Ezekiel. You see, this is how you can add the elements in the array list class. Okay, but here in arrays you have to put the index and then you insert the element, but here you don't need to put the element, you only use the add method to add the elements in the array list. And you can say n dot add so that you can add other elements in the array list. Like here I can say let me say Jim. So you can also add, you can add so many elements. But here, guys, you see we've got so many methods that we can use with the array list. Okay, these are all of the methods that you can use, but today I'm not going to take you through all these methods, because I have done all these methods in the linked list class. Not all, but some of the methods which are supported by the what, by the array list and the what, and the linked list. So here I'm going to show you how to add and how to remove. Okay, I can add the third one as James, and let me print out this n element, and then let me run this. You see here, guys, we have get the, we have managed to get this what, array list, this element that we have added. And if I try to print our string array, the traditional array, let me say I have already called it names, and let me run this again. Let me try to run this again. You see here, guys, here I didn't get the names. Why? Because I have to put the index, and this is the this is also another disadvantage of this. I have to put the index here, like I have to access the element at index 0, at index 1, up to index maybe 2, 3, also just like that. So if I run this, You see here, guys, I have managed to get the element at index 0. So what if I try to add here this element? And let me run this. You see here, guys, exception in thread main, this one, index out of bounds exception. Why? Because I have added three elements, but here I've already said that my array is going to only take two elements. Okay, so this is also the disadvantage that comes with the what, with the traditional arrays. Okay, so here you can remove elements by just saying n dot remove. We can use the remove method, okay, and you can remove the element at the beginning of that of the array list, or you can specify the element that you want to remove. Okay, like if I want to remove Ezekiel, I can explicitly say I want to remove this element, okay, and then if I say n, no, then let me say, okay, and then let me print here. Let me run this again. No. Let me remove this so that you can see. Okay, guys, you see here, guys, here when I print this array list, we've got Ezekiel, Jim, and James. But when I remove this element, Ezekiel, you see here, guys, we have left with the what, with Jim and what, and James. So here you can explicitly state the element that you want to remove, or you can put the index also. I think it have good. If I say n dot remove, you see, guys, you can put any object that you want to remove, or you can put the integer. Here you can put the boolean. You can remove the boolean. Okay. So if I say run this, you see here, guys, it have removed the element at index number 1, and I have left with Ezekiel and James. So here it is 0 1, it is 0 1, you see, that's why it removed this element. Okay, so this is how ArrayList works. Okay, so I have to say thank you, guys, for watching this video. Just for supporting me, just to click the subscribe button. If you like this video, just click the like button, and also don't forget to share this video. I have to say thank you, guys, for staying with me for this video tutorial. See you on the next video. Thank you.